Hi, I'm Eric, and this is my wife, Dr. Sakeisha Hylick of Marriage Can Win.
Here at Marriage Can Win, we educate, empower, and encourage couples to embrace that marriage can win, especially when you focus on three key areas: improving your communication skills, number two, developing sound money management skills so you're not living paycheck to paycheck, and three, enhancing your intimacy skills so your marriage can win.
Now, as a couple in business together, we want to ensure that our business are what?
Profitable.
Yes, profitable. Now, have you ever met an entrepreneur that says, I want to be broke?
I don't think so.
Now, after all, the goal is for each and every one of us to add extra zeros to our bottom line, correct?
Absolutely. Now, logically, this makes sense. However, can we share with you what we've discovered? After working with hundreds of couples, we found out that they had one thing in common. They had excuse after excuse after excuse as to why they weren't making any money in their business. And the truth is, there's no revenue in excuses. Now let's review the five most common excuses that these couples had. Now the first one is what?
There is not enough time.
Now, I think Zig Ziglar said it best when he said, it's a lack of direction, not a lack of time. That's the problem. Because we all have 24 hours in a day. I mean, sometimes we say, there's not enough time. That's something you say because it makes you feel better. It's better than being honest and saying, look, that sounds hard and I just don't want to put in the effort. Now, while it may sound legitimate to say there's not enough time, it's just simply not true.
Now, here's a fun fact. There are 24 hours in a day, 7 days in a week, 365 days in a year, unless it's a leap year.
And we all have the exact same amount of time in a day. Now, let me give you a quick assignment. The next time that you are tempted to say there's just not enough time, replace it with the honest fact that says, that's just not important enough to me to do right now. Now, wouldn't that jog your memory? If you said, or wouldn't that cause you to rethink your things if you're saying there's just not enough time, if you're truly honest with yourself? Which that leads us to our second point, which is now's just not a good time.
Have you ever had an idea that you felt like, whoa, when I release this plan, it's gonna be like fire.
Yeah.
And we gonna get paid. Mm-hmm. But you keep on putting it off and putting it off. Mm-hmm. And when you see someone else doing it, they start killing it and they just getting paid. Don't you feel like kicking yourself?
I mean, during this pandemic, there's absolutely no reason why you, yes, you shouldn't be coming out executing million-dollar ideas. I mean, you got the time, right? You've got access to your audience. You've got your target audience's attention. The I'm busy reason doesn't fly anymore because everyone is pretty much at home. The only thing holding you back is you. This is the most opportune moment to start. A year from now, you'll wish you had started today.
So our next excuse is, I don't have enough money.
Oh my God. You have companies such as Dell, Facebook, Apple, Coca-Cola,
Clorox, Hewlett Packard, Microsoft, Oracle, eBay, SAP, and Cisco.
Now the list goes on and on and on. Now all of these companies were originally bootstrapping companies. They didn't have enough money to get these companies the way they wanted them to. But I don't know about you, but I don't want to leave my future in the hands of a company where they determine how valuable I am or how valuable I'm not. I mean, if you think about it, does that amount of investment outweigh the risk of you staying where you are now? I mean, what have you got to lose? If you look at your 401ks, the values have dropped tremendously. The six-figure job security thing is gone. We are more extendable now as employees than we have ever been. So that I don't have enough money, to me, it doesn't outweigh the risk of staying where you are.
Nope, it doesn't.
Now, the next excuse is someone else is already doing it.
Well, let me ask you this. Everyone has a smartphone.
Yes.
Everyone can take a quick look at your phone. Some of you have Apple, some of you have Android. Is that correct?
Correct.
Now, if Apple ceased on the product, if they ceased to do their product because Android is out there, mm-hmm. what would that do? They wouldn't be here today as one of the most prominent smartphone producers in the world.
You know what? There's a need for both Apple and Android. If you think about it this way, for those of you that are avid runners or joggers, does Nike stop producing because of Under Armour? I mean, you get the picture, right?
Yes.
The same principle applies to your business. Just, you know, think what you can do with your product or service that can help you stand out and connect more with your target market. You stand to benefit. You stand to add more zeros on your bottom line. And I think it's worth it. What about you?
It is exactly worth it. Now, our next excuse is, I'm not good enough.
Oh my gosh, how are you gonna find out unless you try? Before co-founding companies like LinkedIn and investing in companies like PayPal and Airbnb, Mr. Hoffman had an idea. It was a group or a business called SocialNet, where it was like an online dating service and social networking service. But guess what? It ultimately failed. However, he took those same principles and repurposed it into what is now known as LinkedIn. It's still social networking, but now geared towards business-minded individuals. So for you to say I'm not good enough, that excuse is no longer valid. Now, the truth is, you can do this the hard way,
or you can do it the easy way.
Now, we have a word of advice for entrepreneurs. If you keep fighting for your excuses, you get to keep them. But you also get to keep the results that come along with them.
The hard way.
Let me give you a hint. The hard way brings about increased stress, increased pressure, frustration. And I'm sure you business owners might be, I have that anyway in my business. But just think about it. When you're just basically reinventing the wheel, you're adding additional stress and pressure on yourself.
And I don't want to do that. I'd rather do the easy way.
All right. So what's the easy way? I'm sure you're wondering. It's a mindset. There are mindset principles that you can adopt right now to help shift the trajectory of your business. So you want to talk about those mindset principles?
So what time is it?
It's time for a new mindset so you can get new results. Let me say that again. It's time for you to adopt a new mindset so you can start generating new results. So one of the first things that you can do, one of these mindset principles, do
make a personal development a priority for yourself, AKA
invest in like a coach, connect with a mentor. You gotta do something different if you want a different result. Make sense?
Makes sense. So it is now time to take action.
Now, in addition to doing that or connecting, hiring a coach, connecting with a mentor, you need to start taking action by listening to trusted outside perspectives, meaning research what someone else is doing in your field that's killing the game and how are they doing it. Look at your circle of influence. You need to look at the people that are pouring into you and the people that you're connected to. If there are people with the information, with the resources to help propel your business to the next level, it's time to take advantage of it. Does that make sense?
Makes sense.
Now,
makes sense.
I, honestly, they say that you should never be the smartest person in the room. If you are the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room.
That's why I'm always in the room with you.
I have a response.
She's the smartest woman. I don't
No, we balance each other out. And you know what? You made a great point. I'm glad you brought that up. Because if you think about it, we all have our own different strengths and our areas of improvement.
Right.
So when it comes to the technology, nobody can do it like you, babe. I couldn't do it all. I couldn't do this in business on my own without you.
Well, that's why the team works, makes the dream work.
And it's so important for even we connect with other mentors, other businesses that are doing what we aspire to do. They're helping us in terms of the technology, connecting with your customers.
Right.
It's no need to have pride and an ego. You need to cast that aside, especially if you want to add some additional zeros to your banking account.
Right. So what we got to do is we got to focus on our vision.
Yeah.
Because whatever we feed will grow. So it's time to take some serious action. Be mindful that you can have results, not excuses.
You can have results or you can have excuses, but you can't have both and add extra zeros to your bank account. It just will not work. So another one of these mindset principles, in addition to what we were talking about before, is one, recognizing that time is money. Let me say that again. Yes. Time is what?
Money.
All right.
So what are you doing with your time? Are you getting connected on webinars, Zoom calls, or are you listening to podcasts of other people that are just killing it in your desired areas?
What you do with your time is an indication of how badly you want to add those extra zeros to your bank account. For example, you will find that sometimes here in our household, it might be 11 o'clock at night, but what are we doing? We're getting on webinars, Zoom calls. We have a business show called the Happy Entrepreneur Show that we like to watch, and it comes on a lot of times 11 o'clock at night.
Exactly.
But it is absolutely worth it to be able to connect with Shay and the team, and just to be able to see they're connecting you with other people across the globe, other entrepreneurs that are killing it in the game, helping you come up with six-figure sales strategies, helping you create different things on how to generate sales, how to market. That's a wise way of spending your time. Now, I'm sure a lot of people may be thinking, well, I've got this extra time. I'm going to Netflix. I'm going to chill. You are wasting your time. That's an indicator that you're not really serious about putting extra zeros in your bank account.
Exactly, because if you look at the stock market, Netflix is killing it. Yeah. So why are we watching someone else killing it? Not.
You're adding extra zero. Now, like we said before, if you keep fighting for your excuses, then you simply get to keep them. But you do have to deal with the results that will come along with it. Now let me ask you this. What is your why?
If you know me, my why.
Anyway, your why, it's going to be your core source of motivation. So what is motivating you to tap into this space? What's motivating us to work with married couples? And for us, okay, we can, you know, step aside for a moment and be honest.
Yes.
We're, you know, based on our upbringing, we want it to be the change that we want to see in relationships. We didn't want to wind up like our parents, having two, three, four divorces, you know, not having to rely on the state or being a government employee to be able to pay your bills every month.
Right.
COVID-19 just came and told everybody, you have to have an additional stream of income. You got to be an entrepreneur. And guess what? This is not the only time. This might be the first time kind of that something like this has transpired where the entire country was shut down for months, but that doesn't mean that this will be the only time.
Right.
So this is where you need to start executing those plans. It's no time like the present, because your why for doing that is going to come from within.
Right. So you know what we got to do? We have to be stronger than our excuses. Wayne Gretzky said, he said something like this: you miss 100% of the shots that you never take.
Now, let's think about that for a moment. You miss 100% of the shots you never take.
Right.
So just think about those shots that you do take. They may not land you all the way to where you want to be, but you're not going to remain where you are. You're going to keep getting closer and closer and closer to your goal. You're going to keep adding zero after zero after zero to your bank account. So no one has ever said that being an entrepreneur would be easy, but you do get to decide on how you want to show up in this world for yourself. And I believe Andy Henriquez said it best. He says, you have to show up for your life, because if you don't, no one else will. And that's a powerful statement.
Yes. Also, you know what you got to do? Go full out.
That's true. Now, we're making a joke, but going full out is serious. Think about it. Powerful entrepreneurs ask powerful questions.
Right.
We heard that from Trevor Ott. And when you start connecting yourself with people that are power and influence or are able to take your business to the next level, that's the type of mindset shift that you start to experience. So you need to start doing things like creating an accountability group and creating an accountability partner.
Right.
Let me give you a word of advice. Get rid of the yes people. Well, I hate to say get rid of the yes people, but you want to have people in your corner that are going to hold you accountable so you can take your business to the next level. You need someone that when you say you're going to set a deadline, they're going to make you stick to it. No excuse. There should be a no excuse zone within your business. And it might also be helpful to our entrepreneurs. I mean, it was extremely helpful for me to turn one big goal into several smaller goals.
Yes, exactly.
Because one big goal can seem insurmountable, but if you take it and break it down to smaller goals and you start to see progress.
Yes. And a lot of times we get into our comfort zone. We don't want to take those steps.
Right.
But guess what? Revenue is at the end of your comfort zone. So you have to step outside of your comfort zone.
And you know what? That's true. That's powerful. Revenue begins at the end of your comfort zone, because that comfort zone will keep you in a box and it will keep you from producing. It's going to keep you from connecting. It's going to keep you from taking your business to the next level and adding extra zeros to your bottom line. So you can get rid of the fact that there's no revenue in excuses. But when you step outside that comfort zone.
But you know, something that you said too is because when you're in a box, you're only thinking about this box right here, what you can think inside here sometimes. That's why, you know, like you said, when you're investing into webinars, like other people who are just killing it in the areas, you start to think outside of just what you commonly know or what you commonly see or how you grew up, because your perspective may be limited. And so when you start to expand your mind and get out of your comfort zone, because your comfort zone may be where you know your strengths.
Yes.
And so that's why sometimes you have to make an alliances with others that have some strengths, and you go outside of your comfort zone. And then that's where trust comes into place, right?
Yes. Now, one of the things that you said that was so key, it made me think about our entire business structure, how we started out as I'm a pharmacist in the healthcare industry and you're an engineer, but we knew that that was not the end of our story. That wasn't exactly going to be the end of our calling. I could not stay within the confines of that little box that, you know, that they call a pharmacy. I would always go outside of that comfort zone, interact with my customers, and they start sharing with me what they needed. And when we started, we stepped out our comfort zone and started working with married couples, and we started finding out about their that great divide in marriages and relationships, dealing with communication and finance and intimacy. We started hosting conferences and connecting with couples, and we had a conference in which we had financial advisors come in and talk to the couples, and a light bulb went off. They said, wait a minute. You have experience dealing with people. I have experience from the healthcare industry and planning. And my husband has, he's great with numbers. So instead of hiring another company to come in to talk to our couples, we decided to get into the get ourselves certified so we could provide that for our couples. So now we're licensed in multiple states, able to help others as far as estate planning and retirement planning, some investments, and generating additional streams of incomes. Because the truth is, we all want to add those extra zeros to our bottom line. But wouldn't it be amazing to be able to offer products and services that can put your target market in that one-stop shop?
And so that caused us to step out of our comfort zone, because we had been working with couples, coaching and counseling and premarital for like years. Yeah. And so that's why when we, like you said, we brought in another financial institute.
Yeah.
But so now we went ahead and added that, because our, you know, what we did was want to help couples in their communication, their finance, and greater intimacy.
Right.
And so now, instead of doing outside, now we have additional value to offer to couples to help them to build, protect, and save wealth for not only for them and their current generations, but their future generations, which is their legacy.
Now, I have a question for you entrepreneurs that are out there that are watching it. Take a moment and think, what can I do to generate additional streams of income where I don't necessarily have to develop a new skill set? It's something that I can do. And it's going to generate an additional stream of income. It's something that's on the inside of me, something that's already tied to my business, something that's tied to my ideal client. In the healthcare industry, I would have access to 200, 300 clients per day, working 5-6 days a week sometimes. That's access to 1,800 clientele a week. Mm-hmm. I already have access to their healthcare aspect because I manage their medications. I manage what's going on with their health. But then, you know, as a pharmacist, we're trusted. They tell us a lot of their information. So they start sharing with me about their finances, what's going on. So now I'm able to tap into that market and provide an additional benefit or service for them, and that generates an additional stream of income for me.
Yes. So now we must do what?
Act. Yeah, because action changes things. So that means when we tell you to step outside of your comfort zone, there's a reason. If you're staying in within the confines of your comfort zone, you're not going any further than where you are. Remember what we talked about earlier. If you hold on to those excuses, you can have them, but you have the results that come along with them.
No revenue.
But when you act, you start to change things. When we acted and became financial services advisors, in addition to working with our clients, things started to change. We began to help and perform another service for our clientele that was beneficial, and it adds an extra zero to our bottom line.
Exactly. Now, one thing is that we can't do is we just can't say and be speaking and say, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do this, but we never take action, because guess what? Actions speak louder than words.
That's true. I heard this one time. This was really, really powerful. We're sitting in a conference, and I want to say it was one of the Justins that said this. He said, we've done enough learning, now it's time to start doing.
Exactly.
And that really resonated with me, because there's sometimes where we sit in conference after conference after conference, we take in all of this information, and then we do what? We go home and put it on the shelf and wonder why there's not enough revenue in our businesses, because there's no revenue in the excuse. You've got the information, but you've done nothing with it. So as an entrepreneur, your actions have to speak louder than your words. Your clients should see you doing your Zoom calls. They should see you on the webinars. They should see you, you know, being out and being active and offering products and services that are going to help increase your bottom line, but help your customers. Now, how can we do that?
Well, we got to take steps toward that, right?
Actually, that's perfect right there. Because there are three things that you as an entrepreneur can do right now. There's a way that you can pivot so you can start generating extra revenue in your business and not generating any excuses.
Right, no more excuses.
All right. So number one, step one, let's start looking at your pricing strategy. A lot of times as entrepreneurs, we're worrying that our prices are too high. You want to give your friends the friend discount. You want to do
the hookup.
Yeah, you want the hookup. I mean, come on. You want to charge what they feel is fair. When you go into an Apple store, the price is the price. Every now and then, I mean, these phones can cost up to $1,000 or more.
Yes.
But someone that really wants this phone, and it's, you know, your target clientele, they're going to find out a way to take advantage of it, correct?
Correct.
The same thing in regards to your business. Sometimes you price yourself right out of a profit. I'm going to say that again. You price yourself right out of a profit because you're too busy giving out the discount. You need to charge what's fair. The people will pay you when you bring value. So when you're solving their problems, your client is going to be able to pay for, or they will figure out the way.
Now, this does not mean that you can just come in and out of the blue with no training, no value yourself, and try to charge like you have so much value. You must invest in yourself, to increase your value.
Yes.
So if you increase your value, now you have value to give to others. Mm-hmm. And then now that price is also coming along with that value.
Now, you know what this makes me think about? Step number two, which is your product. Think about it. Everyone's familiar with Jeff Bezos. Before he became the Amazon guru, he had a business, and it was like an online auction site that was not really doing well. It wound up turning into this, like what they call a Z shop, and the business ultimately failed. But what did he do? He repurposed it into what eventually became Amazon.
Right.
So just think about it. Sometimes if you're looking at your brand and it's like, I've got a good product, but let's see, sometimes you may have to tweak it a little bit more so that it aligns, it strategically aligns with your target market. If you think about our financial services business, we have multiple product lines, but you have someone that's looking, hey, if this is in their budget, this is going to be the product that we present to them. We're not going to hit you with our $50,000, $100,000 product if you're saying, hey, I can only afford to invest $50 to $100 a month. It doesn't make sense.
Right. And that's why what we do is we work with you, find out your needs, find out what your goals are. If you want to plan for your education for your kids, or if you want to plan for vacations, or if you want to plan for retirement, then that's what we work for you at your budget and what you can afford. Because we're not going to put something that you have to invest $100,000 or $10,000, but maybe all you can invest is $100 a month. But in the time that you need it, say 10 years, when you're ready for your kids to go to college, now you have $80,000 to $100,000 of tax-free income to now take care of your kids' education. And then again, when it's time for you to retire, that would be another path that you'd have to take.
Yeah, so we've talked about your pricing, we've talked about your product. So the third step is your pitch. Make sure that you're targeting your ideal client. I can't say this enough. Everyone is not your ideal client.
Right.
And as much as we love working with marriages, we love working with finances, everyone is not going to be your client. And you have to be mindful of that. You know, we have people that we have different investment products. You know, when we're talking to a potential client and we perform what's called the needs analysis, and they fill out that form and they tell us and it shows us what they need, I'm not going to pitch them on something like this that you don't need. Now, of course, I mean, a business person, you can upsell them on certain products, but you have to be mindful. You don't pitch the $100,000 or the $20,000 product to someone that has a $500 a month budget.
Right.
It may not work.
Exactly.
So you need to just be mindful. So let's just make sure that we're using your pitching to your ideal client. So we want to recap. Remember, we talked about the five most common excuses that entrepreneurs use for not generating revenue. Because remember, there's no revenue in excuses. And we talked about five different mindset principles that you could implement now to shift your mindset, get the new mindset, new results. And then we talked about the three areas in which you need to pivot right now, which would be your pricing, your product, and your pitch in order to generate more revenue and less excuses. But what we do want to do is take this time to just thank each and every one of you for your time and attention.
And also, because we have your attention and you took the time out to let us invest into you, we're going to give you a gift to show our appreciation for you just supporting us. What you can do now, get your cell phone out, right? Now, text WIN, W-I-N, to the phone number 407-258-1246. Again, that's 407-258-1246.
There should actually also be a link on the very bottom, because we're going to give you a free download of our workbook.
Yes.
Which contains assessments to help you discern where the two of you are in your relationship in regards to your communication levels, in regards to your finance levels, and in regards to your intimacy. And what is through completing these assessments, you can see where you are and start to determine where you want to be. And specifically for those of you who want to focus on the financial aspect, you can see where, if you're using those five excuses, if not, you need to start in, you know, incorporating those five mindset principles and start to consider those three areas in which you need to pivot. So we just want to say thank you again so much for your time and attention. And you guys have an amazing day.
Bye now.